Hey guys, welcome to another very exciting tutorial of creation process. And today we're going to make a vector speedometer icon. So let's begin. I'll take Ellipse tool and make an ellipse. Change its color to black. Please see that I have removed the outline of the curves object, so it should be null and body should be black. Now duplicate it by clicking with the alt and mouse drag. Keep it over it and scale it down a little bit and change its color. I'll apply some gradient, so I have chosen the gradient and change this color to a little bit darker tone. Click on it and you'll see the palette, color palette. Choose any color. Radial color and just play with the gradient until you feel it right. This just give some lighter tone over here because I want some changing color effect, and here a little bit brighter. Okay, now with the gradient adjust the tone. When it's done, duplicate one more time with the alt and mouse click. Keep it over it. Yep, and scale it down a little bit. Now change its color to black. And before that, just scale it up this one a little bit more. Yep, it will create a boundary and this will be our body. Now duplicate one more time. Okay, now scale down a little bit and change its color to white. Yeah, pretty cool white. And but it's looking very flat, so I use some gradient apply here. So I'll choose the gradient, change it to linear, make it white, and this one little bit gray. And now with the gradient tool, I will play with the gradient. I'll make it vertically like this, gray on the top and white on the bottom. It will feel, it will give it some 3D feel. Now you see, and this I'll apply some gradient too. I'll change it to linear and I'll play with it. Lighter on the upper side and darker on the lower side. Yep. So when it's done, now it's time to make some detail. So I'll take a rectangle, keep it over here. Make it change it to black. Okay, now you can adjust it somewhere here. Alt and duplicate, drag and keep it here. Okay, it should be moving along the center. Yep, this is the center. In the same way, keep it in the center. Yep. Now select both of this stuff and Windows Pathfinder combine. Now what I have done is it's one object. Now its center point is here and I can rotate anywhere. So with the rotation tool I can rotate it any with in any angle. With the same perfection, so you can rotate it. Now what I would do is I'll just rotate alt, wait, I'll with the rotation tool I'll preview it. I'll rotate to an angle, let's say it's 0 5 degree, and preview it. Or let's say I want some 1 2 3 4 7 8 9 10 11 12, so 360 divided by 12, what do you get? Let's just check it out in accessories. 360 divided by 12 equal to 30 degrees. So I'll put some 30 degree difference copy, control D, 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 D. That's all. This is the way you can make a perfect divisions. Now what I've got is, well, the next step which I am going to do is small rectangle and yep, this much. I'll change its color to red. It's Creatn, so you can change its color from here and can apply the red from here. In the same way, I'll do the same stuff. So what I need is, I need four here. So means this to this, it's 30 degree. Between that, I need four. So what would I do is, before that, just duplicate it one more time. I'll duplicate it and you drag it down to its lower point. And match the alignments. Then select both, okay, combine it. Now width four. Okay, 30 divided by 4, what do you get? That's in the calculator. We have 30 divided by 4, 7.5. so let's apply some rotation here. 7.5, copy, control D, 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 D. So you get a proper design. Now I'll delete this which I don't need. Now almost, you see there's a proper division and proper design. So next, what I'll make is, I'll make a smaller duplicate one more time, bring it to the, arrange it to the front, change its color to gradient, and let's apply some gradient. I'll make this black, dark, a little bit brighter, play with the gradient. Okay, now when it's done, scale it down to a bit, little bit smaller. I'll put it in the center. Now I'll take a rectangle, change its color to red. With the pen tool, over there is a delete anchor point. I'll delete one of the anchor point. Okay, right, the red. With the selection tool, you can move the anchor points. Now let's fit it on this scene. So let's scale it down. Play with the selection tool, you can scale it down easily. So yep, scale it down a little bit. So just remove this. Yeah, now over here we'll keep it here, scale it a little bit up. So arrange to backward and let's turn it a little bit, and I'll keep it here. Now that's some readings, some values on the design. So I'll take some values, 20,
you have to put some value so that it's like a speedometer, and there should be some value in there. Something, some value. So let's have 100, then 120, 140, and 160. That's all. We'll put this much of value.
So scale it on a little bit down. Now place it in their positions. I'll place it here. 40 here, 160, I'll duplicate here. Let's make it 80. So So after putting the values, next step is we need a small meter. So I'll make a take a rectangle, make it black. Now with the text, alright, one, okay. I'll keep it on the top of it, change its color to white. Just arrange it equally so that there should not be any irregularity. It should be uniform. I drag it here and scale it up a little bit. Now we'll add some reflections. Duplicate it with the Alt and drag. Arrange it in front. Make it white. Let's duplicate one more to cut this stuff. Select both. I'm really using the Pathfinder. Subtract. No. Just use this tool, which is intersect. Now apply some gradient. I'll change this color to white. And I'll reduce its opacity to 0. Now using the gradient tool, just play with the gradient. So you see some reflection over here. You can put some details over here. Yeah, but I'll make this color a little bit darker. In this way you can apply some gradient tool, which will make your product a little bit of realism, which will now add some reflection. That's some shadow. I will keep it below it. I'll arrange it on the back side. Okay, a little bit smaller, thinner. Now I'll change its color to black. Here a little bit of gray. Now I'll go to Effect, Blur, Gaussian Blur. I'll preview it, how it will look. I'll increase the blurness, a little bit of blurness. And I think it's fine, okay. Reduce the opacity by going into a layer, or you can select here and just go to transparency and reduce the opacity to 50%. When it's done, I'll increase it by a little bit of 70% or maybe 80%. Yeah, that's fine. Now, Control G to group it. Yep. Now, okay, after that, just plate it over here. I'll scale it up a little bit. I'll duplicate one more time. Yeah, I'll select and scale it up a little bit. It should fill the screen. Now we'll give some dramatic effect over here. You'll see that every clock, every watch, every stop, this pedometer is looking very sharp. So if these two guys are on the back side, I'll give some blurness effect so that it will may feel that it's on the back side. So I'll go to Effect, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Apply some blurriness effect with the preview. You can see the how blurry it's going to be on the back side. Okay, let's give some little bit of blurriness and click OK. Now you'll see it's sharp at the back side. Blur. This is how you can make your speedometer. Thank you very much.